Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Innal hamdalillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh wa na'udzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyiati a'malina. May yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa may yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun wa ba'du. Fa inna asdaqal hadis kitabullah wa khairul hadi hadu Muhammadin sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa syarrul umuri muhdatsatuha wa kullu muhdatsatin bid'ah wa kullu bid'atin dalalah wa kullu dalalatin finnar. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah, with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have been able to be here together to perform our Jummah today, inshallah. And we do know the benefit of performing Jummah prayer, the significant, the fadilat of Jummah. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam remind us, al-Jummah ila Jummah muqaffarat bainahuma. From one Jummah to another Jummah, whatever sins that we have committed, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the weekly sin. Ameen. And again the Prophet said, as-salah ila salah muqaffarat bainahuma. Between the two salat also, Allah will forgive our sins. We need Allah to forgive our sin because we have been committing sins almost every day. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam always remind his ummah by reciting the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ali Imran, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu ittaqillah. O you who believe in Allah, so Allah is addressing all of us because we are believers. But in the same time, we must understand what is iman. When you talk about believer, you are talking about iman. Iman is not just a word. Iman is just not just lip service. It's not how you dress, what you say. But iman have a lot of things to do with amanah. The Prophet said, La iman liman la amanatala. There's no iman for people who have no amanah. Deen is our amanah. Our deen, Islam, is an amanah. The Quran is an amanah. Whatever Allah wants us to do, the five pillars of Islam is an amanah. And when we talk about deen of Islam, you're not talking about just the ritual, not salat. But salat want us to become people who are always involved in amal ma'ruf and nahi munkar. Anything that you want to do in the deen of Islam, there is adab. Adab towards Allah. To know Allah, to believe in Allah, you must have knowledge. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Even to know Allah, to believe in Allah, you must have knowledge. Without the proper knowledge, that means you have no adab with Allah. You cannot talk about Allah in any way you like, how you feel, no. You want to talk about Allah, you must have the knowledge of Allah. And the knowledge of Allah is in His book, Al-Quran. How do Allah talk about Himself? How do Allah present Himself? That's how we should present Allah. Not according to how we feel, no. Just an example, the adab with Allah. If anybody asks us, where is Allah? You cannot say Allah is everywhere, because Allah never says He is everywhere. There's no adab. Don't talk about Allah without referring to His word, His book. Because the Quran is here to represent Allah. Wa kalam Allah, the speech of Allah. In the time of the Prophet, when the people asked, or even the Prophet asked one slave woman, where is Allah? She said, Allah is Sama. The Prophet said, she's telling the truth. she have iman. This is just an example. Even with Allah, you must have adab. You cannot talk about Allah without referring to the book of Allah. The adab with the Prophet, we say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. We bear witness now that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And we know, you cannot just say, this is a sunnah, without any dalil from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tradition cannot be a sunnah. A sunnah we know is qawlihi wa fi'lihi wa taqrili. The saying of the Prophet, the action of the Prophet is a sunnah. And also, something that happened in the time of the Prophet never made any comment. It is also a sunnah. That means the Prophet approved. But other than that, you cannot make a sunnah something that you think is a sunnah, but it's not from the Prophet, because the Prophet said, Man qala alayya ma lam akul, falyatabawwaq maq'adahu minan nar. Whoever dares say something that I, Prophet Muhammad, didn't say, you say, sunnah. Who said sunnah? You said sunnah. We have the right to say sunnah? No. Only the Prophet have the right to say this is a sunnah. Whoever say something and he used the name of the Prophet where the Prophet didn't say it, now he is putting himself in the hellfire. You cannot say anything about Prophet Muhammad without the knowledge of his sunnah. This is adab to the Prophet. And that's why Allah even said to us, we must have adab in our deen. Our deen is based on shahadatayn. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. And what did Allah say in Surah Al-Hujurat? Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, la tuqaddimu bayna yadayillahi wa rasulihi wa taqallah, inna Allah as-sami'un alim. O you who believe in Allah. Allah said that, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O you who believe in Allah. La tuqaddimu, you are not supposed to put the saying of anybody, the saying of your father, the saying of the of an imam, a sheikh, above the command of Allah and the saying of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the first adab. And then follow up with Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَارَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. It is not permissible for any believers, male or female, when Allah and the Prophet have decided something for you, when Allah and the Prophet have fixed something for us, we still said, I know, this is what Allah said, I know this is what Prophet said, but no, let me check with my father, let me check with my mother, let me check with my sheikh, let me check with my friend. Is your friend more important than Allah and the Prophet? This is just an azab, adab. The adab toward yourself, وَلِنَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقْ, the Prophet said, every one of us, our body have right upon us. Make sure that you don't eat haram food, you don't drink haram drink, you don't dress haram dress, and come to Jumu'ah. Because you have no adab to yourself, because yourself have right upon you. And brothers and sisters, now is Jumu'ah, alhamdulillah. There's adab in Jumu'ah. One of the adab before you come to Jumu'ah, you should take a bath, ghusl. Adab. Make sure that you are properly clean. And you wear the best dress. And then when you come to the mosque, make sure that you honor the adab of the mosque. Islam is rich with adab. How to talk to people, how to enter people's house, and this is not your house, not my house, this is home of Allah. Masjid. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ. Indeed, all masjid belong to Allah. When you enter the masjid, you have no right to sit down. One day the companion came in late when the Prophet was giving khutbah. Prophet was giving khutbah. Not daras, not bayan like now. He was addressing his ummah and giving khutbah. And Abu Darda came in and he said, he just sit down because he want to respect the khutbah. What did the Prophet say? Immediately the Prophet asked Abu Darda, "Hal salaita? Have you performed your prayer? Tahatul masjid?" He said, "La, ma salaitu ya Rasulullah. Qum fa salli raka'atain." Immediately the Prophet advised this man, companion, stand up now and perform two raka'at. And the Prophet said, "Iza dakhla ahadukum al-masjid, fala yajlis hatta yusalli raka'atain." Any one of you enter the mosque, don't sit. You cannot sit until you perform two raka'at tahiyatul masjid. If it's not important, the Prophet will let Abu Darda sit and listen to the khutbah. Some opinion, some people may say, it's okay, the khutbah is on. But if you do not want to sit, or if you do not want to pray, you have the right. But don't sit. You are late, Imam will give khutbah, you just stand. Until the end of khutbah, and you join the fard prayer. And no tahiyatul masjid. But if you want to sit, the adab of the masjid must be honored. And the imam is going to give a khutbah. When the khutbah is on, you see, this shows us the imam can talk to the ma'mum can respond, they can communicate. But the ma'mum and ma'mum cannot talk to each other. If you speak, if you're on your handphone and you play SMS, there's no adab of Jummah. Because khutbah is like salah. Everybody must be silent, complete silent, whether you understand the khutbah or not. It is our duty to honor the khutbah. You must listen. Even if somebody is talking, if you say, unsit, keep quiet. Fakal lagaw. Finish. You commit a sin by doing that. Because it's like praying. When people are praying, can you say, stop doing this, stop moving, you know, stop scratching. You cannot say that. Because he is making prayer. This is adab. And then later on, we are going to listen to the khutbah with full of concentration. Everybody must be silent, complete silent. And there are a lot of people who are silent that fall asleep. No, you must listen, keep yourself awake. And then the Jama'ah prayer is going to start after the khutbah. And the imam is going to say, Aqimus Salah. Meaning we got to stand up. There's adab in performing prayer in Jama'ah. Beautiful Islam. Everything that is adab. Salat the Jama'ah, what did the Prophet say? The first thing that you must honor the adab of Jama'ah so that you got 27 reward from Allah, comparing with salat alone, is you must make sure your saf is straight. Stawuf sufufakum. Tarasu taqarrabu saddal khala. Stand close to each other, shoulder to shoulder, feet to feet. Leave no gaps among yourself. وَمَنْ وَصَلَ صَفًّا وَصَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ وَمَنْ قَطَعَ صَفًّا قَطَعَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Whoever purposely do not want to join the saf, cut the saf, Allah will cut the relationship with him. But whoever join the saf, Allah will join the communication with him. It's a very serious matter. It's adab jama'ah. You want 27 reward, you don't want to stand close to each other. You want to have your space. Then you better pray alone. This is the congregational prayer, Jama'ah. Jama'ah is you touch feet to feet, shoulder to shoulder. Just Allah will unite your heart. If you are united in your salah, you will be united outside salah. Now we have failed. Because we have no adab. And when you follow the imam, there is another adab. Allahu Akbar. إِنَّمَا جُئِلَ الْإِمَامِ لِيُؤْتَمَ بِهِ فَإِذَا قَبَّرَ فَقَبِّرُوا وَلَا تُقَبِّرُوا حَتَّى يُقَبِّرُ وَإِذَا رَقَعَ فَارْقَعُوا وَلَا تَرْقَعُوا حَتَّى يَرْقَعُ وَإِذَا قَالَ إِمَامْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ فَقُولُوا رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَإِذَا سَجَدَ فَاسْجُدُوا وَلَا تَسْجُدُوا حَتَّى يَسْجُدُ إِلَى الْآخِرَةِ حَدِيثٌ. Imam is made for you to follow. Follow. When the imam make takbir, you ma'mum should start your takbir. But none of you should start to make takbir until hatta yuqabbir. Imam have completed his takbir. And this is important. Now how can you know the imam have completed his takbir? You are in the second saf, last saf, the sister in the other area. You can see the imam. You cannot pray and look at the imam. No. You must be focused. Look at the place where you put your forehead. Makanya sujud. But at least you must hold on, be patient. Make sure that you wait until the imam finish his recitation. Allahu Akbar. Sami Allahu liman hamidah. Allahu Akbar. When his recitation end, we believe the imam have completed his movement. Because Al-Bara'a ibn Azib radiallahu anhu said, when we, the companions of the Prophet, follow our imam, follow the Prophet in the Salatul Jama'ah, Salatul Fard, none of us move from one position to another until we are sure the Prophet have completed his movement. None of us move from standing to sujood until we are sure the Prophet wada jabtahu alal ar, the Prophet have put his forehead on the ground. That means the Prophet have completed his sujood. Because sometimes the imam may be a bit late, and if you start together with his takbir, you may be ahead of the imam. Then how can you have the reward of jama'ah? When you perform your prayer and your movement is ahead of the imam, then you commit a sin. You are not a ma'mum. You are like a imam. And the Prophet forbid us to compete in with him in our movement, takbir, ruku, wa sujud. This is very important, brother. It's discipline. Islam is all about discipline. Discipline when you eat, when you drink, use your right hand, don't use your left hand. Your discipline towards your neighbor. The Prophet said, "Man kana yu'minu billahi yawmal akhir falyukrim jarahu." Whoever believes in Allah and the Day of Judgment, he must honor his neighbor. Whether the neighbor is a Muslim or not yet Muslim, they are your neighbor. Adab. "Man kana yu'minu billahi yawmal akhir falyukrim dayifahu." Whoever believes in Allah and the Day of Judgment, you must honor and respect your guest. Whether he is a Muslim guest or not yet Muslim guest, a guest is a guest. And the Prophet ﷺ remind us again, "Laysa minna man lam yuqir kabirana wa lam yarham saghirana." Adab. You are not one of us if the young do not know how to respect the elders, and the elder do not know how to love the young one. It's adab. How do you talk to the elderly people? You must have adab. Likulli makan, likulli maqal maqam, likulli maqal maqam. Every word there's a place, every place there's a word. You have adab to the imam, to your parent. You cannot raise up your voice talking to your parent. When you want to attend darus, there's adab in majlis ilm. When you seek knowledge, there is adab. You must respect your teacher. One, the Prophet said, "Man waqara aliman faqad waqara rabbah." Whoever honor his teacher, honor a scholar, he is honoring Allah. How can you get the blessing from your teacher who is going to make and ask Allah to bless you? For the time you spend with him seeking knowledge, when you don't even respect him. When he talk, you talk. You don't listen. Even seeking knowledge, there is adab. The adab of seeking knowledge, number one, you must make sure your intention is for Allah. Ikhlas lillah. Not for dunya. Not to show off. And second thing, after you learn, you must understand whatever you learn, right? Reciting the Quran, the adab of reciting Quran, if you must recite properly, and after reciting properly, you must understand the verses of Allah. And after you understand the adab of the knowledge, is you must act upon the knowledge. If not, then you become the people Dan Allah said lima taquluna ma la taf'alun qabra maqtan innallaha an taqulu ma la taf'alun. Don't become like the people who like to talk about something when they don't even do what they say. And Allah hate these people. We do not want to have a lot of talking Muslim, but very rare. You say talking Muslim everywhere. Practicing Muslim very rare. We don't want to be like that. We want quality Muslim. And after you have understand the knowledge, you act upon the knowledge, lastly, you must convey the knowledge. You cannot keep the knowledge to yourself, because knowledge is amanah. Wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddis. Every ni'mah you must share with other people. You cannot keep it to yourself. I want to go to Jannah. I want to go to Jannah. How about others? You don't care about others. You don't care about your neighbor. You don't care about children. You don't care about your wife. What kind of man is this? Adab of family. Take care of your family. Amanah. You must act upon the knowledge and share the knowledge. The Prophet said, "Balligh anni walau ayah." Convey from me even one ayah that you understand. You act upon that ayah. You must share it with other people. By doing that, brothers and sisters, inshallah, we believe that in tansurullah yansurkum wa yusabbi aqdamakum. Whoever help the religion of Allah, uphold the teaching of Islam, Allah is sure to help you. When Allah is going to help us, nobody can cause harm to us. And Allah will make us steadfast, make us strong in this world, and He will make us strong in the hereafter. Even when we die, if the angel of Munkar Nakir asks us, we have no problem. We are ready to answer the question in the Qubur. In Akhirah, we are ready for everything. So brothers and sisters, let us respond to the call of Allah. Allah said, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu udkhulu fis-silmi kaffa wa la tattabi'u khutuwatish shaitan innahu lakum adu'un mubin. O you who believe, enter Islam totally. Islamize your heart, your mind, your eye, your hearing, your speech, your hand, your leg. Enter Islam bodily, physically, mentally, and spiritually. May Allah bless us. May Allah guide us. May Allah accept all our deeds, forgive all our sins. And may Allah strengthen the unity among this ummah. Because we are the best ummah. Kuntum khairah ummah, ukhrijat linnasi, ta'amuruna bil ma'ruf, wa tanhauna animunkaw, wa tu'minuna billah. Wa billahi tufiqil akhridah da'wana, innal hukma illa lillahi. عليه توكلت فعليه يتوكل المتوكلون سبحانك اللهم بحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته